What if someone told you that life on Earth was the product of blind, undirected processes? And the notion of purposeful design in nature was destroyed by Darwin's theory in the 19th century? What if explanations for the genius of the animal kingdom were limited to natural selection and errors in the DNA code? And if schools taught that the origin of eagles, whales, and monarch butterflies was once determined by the luck of the draw in a genetic lottery? What if science insisted that the hypothesis of a creator is nothing more than a bedtime story, and reality itself is merely random interactions of matter and energy? How would you respond? Could you disagree with confidence and conviction? Now you can. The Design of Life Collection. Since Aristotle, scientists have studied the eggs of a chicken to unlock the mysteries of a bird's development from a single cell.
Remember that all birds develop in the same way. So if I'm looking at a superb flying bird, let's say a swift or a swallow or something like that, it's going to develop in about the same way as a chicken embryo develops. And every mechanism that is necessary for flight, every adaptation for flight that you find in doves, that you find in eagles, vultures, they're all there in a chicken.
The developmental process begins soon after fertilization and accelerates once the egg is laid, as thousands of cells rapidly multiply and organize inside the protective shell.
In the early hours, you see the foundation for this organism that's coming later on being laid down. You see the front and the back and the top and the bottom and all of those things being worked out in this cascade of events.
Where's the head going to be? Where's the tail going to be? What's right, what's left, what's front versus back? Already, these major axes are being established. And as these cells are moving and heading towards the places in the embryo where they're going to develop, they're also changing what they're going to do eventually. They're committing themselves, in most cases, irreversibly to particular functional roles.
On day two, the bird's spinal cord, ears, and eyes take shape. Its vascular and circulatory systems are established, and its heart beats for the first time. At hour 46, the head of the embryo starts to arch into the fetal position. Throughout the second day, a network of blood vessels branches from the embryo into the yolk. They will transport vital nutrients back to the growing organism.
You gotta pay attention to the details. You have genes being switched on and off, interaction, cell communication. It's an elaborate dance. It's like a ballet taking place on a stage with thousands of cast members. All of them doing everything they're supposed to on cue, in the right order, in the right sequence, in the right time. The process itself is so amazing. It transcends anything we know.
With the groundwork of major systems and organs now in place, the next 19 days are devoted to the completion of their development.
So you've gone from that one cell that can become anything, and 21 days, billions of different cells doing hundreds and hundreds of different kinds of tasks in the organism. The speed, the efficiency, the elegance of the whole process. What you're seeing is a mechanism at work, information being translated into a physical product at each step along the way. Machines doing jobs. It's absolutely incredible. Absolutely incredible.
Every bird born into the world starts life preoccupied with the same obsessions. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Weak and often blind for several days, most nestlings are totally reliant upon their parents for food. And they quickly learn to associate the vibrations made by an adult landing near the nest with the arrival of their next meal. As the young birds grow, their muscles strengthen. Primary feathers fill out and align, and functional wings take shape. All in preparation for the endeavor that will define the rest of their lives. Flight.
The parents aren't going to feed them forever. In fact, that's one of the encouragements that parents will give baby birds to fly. They'll move a distance away from them, not give them their food in the nest, so they have to come out. And you'll see baby birds working their way up to this. You know, they'll be standing on the edge of the nest and just getting the feel for what those wings can do for them.
Oceanic birds on remote islands, they'll spend days watching their parents before ever attempting that first flight. And we have to assume they're fast learners. Here's this feathered downy chick that gets bigger and bigger, and some adult feathers start coming through the down. But finally, it has his wings, so he spends all day taking periodic flaps of his wings on the ground to build up his wing muscles. And then comes the big day when mother or father says, it's time to go, and they nudge him towards the cliff.